Hello everyone. In this tutorial, I'm going to tell you how to timewarp a 3D camera inside of Flame. Let me tell you about this footages. Here I have a source footage. It is a drone shot. It has a significant lens distortion. It is 250 frames and 25 FPS. And I 3D tracked this scene in Blender. I have a good solution and I have some geometries on it, and I exported the viewport render of the Blender, and I exported on distortion map and distortion map, and I'm going to reconstruct the scene inside of Flame. First of all, I am undistorting the image using a distortion map. The banded lines are getting straight after I undistort the image. And then I'm cropping this image into project resolution. And I'm adding an action that has a 3D camera and geometries inside of it. When I compare Blender's viewport render and my actions render, they are identical. Everything is aligned perfectly. So my workflow is working correctly. What I'm going to do is time warp this camera, this 3D camera inside of action. For doing that, I will duplicate my action and attach it to itself. And I have two identical actions. And I'm going to color correct these geometries into red. And when you compare the background and result view, the red geometries are on top of the white ones and they are aligned perfectly. And I'm going to insert the time warp node in between. I'm going to enter some keyframes here. I should be in timing mode and my interpolation should be in motion. In the first frame, I will enter 1. In frame 100, I will enter 250. Now my clip is faster now. And I will go to its animation. And when I check the timing channel, it's a straight line. I will change its interpolation to Hermite and make a complex curve like this. And I'm going to rename this time warp node as TW. I select this name because it's shorter and easy to remember. And I go inside of this action and rename my camera as Cam 3D. I'm renaming this because it is shorter and easy to remember, and I'm going to duplicate this camera. This new camera will be my time warp camera, so I'm going to rename it Cam_timer. I'm going to write an expression to time warp it. My expression will take the values from the original 3D camera and put these values into corresponding frames that are coming from this time warp node. So I'm going to use the timing channel of this time warp node. So this name is important. And this Cam3D naming is important. Let's write the expression. My expression will be eval, open parenthesis, Cam3D. Now it gets the values from here, comma, timewarp.timing. close parentheses. This T is in capital letters. It is important. If you write it wrong, then the expression will not work. When I press enter, now as you see, there's a circle here that is yellow. It indicates that there is an expression on this time warp camera. And when you press result, when you scrub the timeline, it is not working now because action still uses this camera 3D. I should switch the camera 3D to camera time warp. When you press F4 for the result view, now my 3D camera is time warped and everything is aligned perfectly. I have a success time warping the camera. There is another case. I'm going to duplicate this time warp knob and attach it to the action again. This time I'm going to change the frame interpolation from motion to mix. What is the difference between motion interpolation and mix interpolation? If you compare two time warps, the result is a little bit different. This time warp renders actually this frame, 84.38. It is using these decimal numbers, but in this time warp, Flame is rendering only 84. It is canceling these decimal numbers. It is deleting it. It is rounding the number to 84. So when I attach this action to this time warp, now as you see, the geometries are not aligned in some frames. So I should change my expression and I should also modify the time warp mode. I'm going to write an expression that is taking the timing values and rounding to whole numbers, the left side. So go to animation, select check timing channel and write an expression. Our expression will be floor, open parenthesis, time warp dot timing, close parenthesis. Now this expression is taking the time warp values and rounding it to integer numbers. When you press enter, as you see, the timing is a whole number, not decimal numbers. Check this number. When I select the time warp knob, it has decimal numbers. Now it has whole numbers. If you zoom into the curve, as you see, it is steppy. Now we have only the numbers left side. And I'm going to rename this knob as timewarp_mix. So I'm going to modify my expression inside of this action and I'm going to use this time warp timing channel. This channel. So I'm going to use timewarp_mix. Go to the action, select our time warp camera and rewrite the expression and modify this field type timewarp_mix. When I press enter and check the result, my new time warp camera, it works perfectly. This time warp is rounding the numbers coming from here, and this new camera is taking the timing values from here. And you can export this scene as FPX, but before exporting, you should bake the animation, and while exporting as FPX, also you should take care to use unit pixels in one. Also while importing, you should use values, that is one, it should be always one. And while importing an Alembic file, your FPS should be 25 because this project and the motion tracking is also 25. You should obey this frame percentage. And that's all. Thanks for watching. Bye.